It's fantastic to have you here for this night. You're looking forward to the album launch?
Absolutely, yeah. Watched Sam, obviously, through X Factor, and a great voice, great person, great personality. So my wife's a big fan as well. So, yeah, looking forward to hearing a few songs tonight, a sneak preview of the forthcoming album.
It's obviously an exciting night tonight, and we're very excited as well, of course, about the start of Rio. How are you feeling about that yourself?
Yeah, obviously excited. So two great things happening within 24 hours, obviously the start of the Olympic Games. So looking forward to a good Games. Hope all the bad press that it's had with all the drugs problems gets put to one side, and we can now see just see some great Games, some great performances, and hopefully come home with a sack full of medals.
I mean, on a positive note, what's the true spirit of the Olympic? What is the magic of that particular sporting event?
I think the first thing is, first of all, competing at an Olympic Games. It's the pinnacle of any Olympian. They want to be competing at Olympic Games. That's first and foremost. And there is a small percentage of people that want to come away with some serious hardware. Everybody want to go there and deliver their best performance, whether that's good enough to make a final, win a bronze, win a gold, or even break a world record. But, you know, first and foremost, it's to go there and perform at your best.
And in terms of your own Olympic experience, obviously, in a strange way, it's inspired so many people. How do you feel about what your own experience and struggles have meant to others?
As I've been saying, because it was 24 years yesterday, being the 3rd of August that incident happened in the semi-finals in Barcelona. Worst minute of my life, but, you know, inspired lots of people. And there was a tweet that, or an image that went around via Facebook that's had about 20 million hits. So it's amazing what it does for other people, but still, you know, a hard pill for me to swallow.
I mean, as the time made it easier to look back on that experience, I mean, have you watched the footage, and kind of how does that affect you when you see it now?
It's still frustrating. I still get frustrated with, you know, looking at it, because I was, you know, on target for a medal, gold, you know, silver, possibly gold. So of course it's hard, of course it's frustrating, but I'm still amazed at the reaction I get and the good that it's done for people, you know, over 24 years.
I mean, obviously that moment when your dad joins you on the track, I think, seems to just transcend people's normal experience of watching a sporting event. Can you talk about your feelings when you saw him come out onto the track with you?
Well, it's hard to say, because obviously my feelings was frustration. All I wanted to do was finish the race. It wasn't until years later that I kind of got what people got. So, you know, asking me how I felt about it on the day, obviously I was very upset, wanted to complete the race. That was all that was on my mind, to be honest with you. I was Olympian, whether that happened or not. If that hadn't happened, I possibly wouldn't have been Olympian with a medal. So it wouldn't have changed what it's like to be an Olympian, because win, lose or draw, if you're an Olympian, you're an Olympian. But obviously that day has, I don't know, changed the way that I'm perceived. Rather than being a medalist, I'm sort of seen now as somebody that personifies what it is to compete in Olympic Games. And actually, I possibly wouldn't be as famous if I'd won the medal as I am by that particular incident happening. Yes, I do a lot of speaking, obviously, and that particular subject comes up. I'm also a group performance director of a company called Thomas International. We're in the assessments, the assessment side of things, and, you know, and we're in the sports sector, business sector and the education sector, and we're basically changing people's lives, and that is something that really does, you know, resonate with me, not only from what I've done in the world of sport, but taking what I've done in the world of sport and helping people be the best that they can be in the world, business, education and sport.